Hello, this is Marc from the MeTechie channel. Thanks for joining me on this video. Today we're learning about something very, very specific. We're learning about how to add captions to your Thinkific videos using a service called rev.com. So two different services. We've got Thinkific over here. We've got rev.com over here. Thinkific allows me to create courses. It allows me to upload videos and create a course that can be sold. I'm a course creator. Then rev.com over here is a service that allows you to take a video, upload a video, or link to a video, give them a URL, and they will transcribe, or that service will transcribe the video and create captions / subtitles. It can do both. And you can either have a machine do it or a real human do it. In this particular example, I'm going to show you what the machines have done, and we will use that caption from rev.com and insert it into a Thinkific video and associate that. Essentially, at the end of the day, we'll have a Thinkific course complete with videos and English subtitles for the listener or the watcher. And the reason why this is interesting is because a lot of my students are international. In fact, 70% of the people that watch my YouTube channel watch it outside the US. So having subtitles is really important. It's not that they're hard of hearing, it's that they have English as a second language. So by seeing the English text, it makes it that much easier to follow along with the spoken word. They hear me, but if they hear me and then see the English subtitles, it actually helps them understand and it's just better for them. In addition, once you have proper subtitles on a YouTube video like this, which I also use rev.com for, once you go that route, you have a picture-perfect subtitle set under that video, and then that allows the user to translate, to use automatic translate, which is something built into YouTube, to translate it into their native language. And there's dozens, if not hundreds, of languages that YouTube translates. But in this case, we're talking specifically about Thinkific. So if you're a Thinkific course creator, join me, and I'll show you how we get this done. All right, so if you have Thinkific, then you'll already know where we're at. We're at the video library. And I have three or four courses now, and each one of those courses has dozens, if not hundreds, of videos. So the first thing I do, and here's a little tip for you Thinkific people out there, I have a prefix on all my videos so that I know what video course, or what course that video goes to. So I have a Nord Electro 6, I have a Nord Stage 3, and by the way, I teach musicians all over the world how to program their Nord keyboard synthesizers. So in other words, professional keyboardists, whether they're piano players, organ players, or synthesizer players, I teach them how to program these Nord keyboards. And this is something I use Thinkific to do, and it's pretty remarkable. It's a very niche business, but the music industry is huge, and these Nord keyboards are pretty popular for the professional. And a lot of people can play great music, really master the keyboard. I don't need to teach them how to play, but a lot of them are not as technically savvy as a computer guy, and I'm a born and bred computer guy as well as a musician, so I bring those two disciplines together, and that's what I teach. So let me show you what I'm working on. I'm working on the Nord Stage 3 course, so I'll first put in NS3, Nord Stage 3. That brings up all my Nord Stage 3 videos, which there are over 100. It's a 14-hour course. It's a monster. It took hundreds of hours to create, but it is my flagship, and people appreciate taking it because it's pretty complete and pretty comprehensive. It really talks about the keyboard from A to Z, and there's over 110 knobs and buttons on that keyboard, so it really does take a course to figure it all out for some. Now, the video I'm working on today is the Nord Stage 3 promo, and this is actually the video that I put at the beginning of my course. It's sort of it doubles as a sales and marketing video along with the free video they would see when they get to the landing page of the course. So it's called the NS3 promo. Then here's a tip. I hold the command key while I push the edit box. That preserves my already filtered list, which I don't want to ruin by hitting the back button. If you've ever done that, it drives you crazy because then you have to keep filtering and filtering. So this is now preserved, and now I have a brand new tab up here because I held the command key. And that tab now shows me the detail of my promo video. Now, if you look closely under captions, and for those of you who've never done this before, you probably just glance over this particular area. I know I did. I completely ignored that. I just focus on the preview, the thumbnail, and forget the captions. I barely look at the appearance. Sometimes I look at the statistics. Look at this one, over 1,050 plays. Pretty good. With the last view on the 5th. All right. Let's click upload when we're ready, but we're not ready yet. So this is where we're going to put the caption file when we're done. So you might ask yourself, well, how do I get these captions in the first place? So I'll create a new tab here and we'll head on over to rev.com. Some of you may already be familiar with this. This is a pretty popular captioning subtitle service. They have a lot of interesting things. Let me log in here and I'll show you some of the options that you have. Here we go, logging in. All right, so let's take a look at my files. So I'll go and click My Files. Now, I've already set a lot of my videos for captioning. What you do is you just place a new order and you decide what type of order you want it to be. For the most part, you'll click Captions. And at this point, you can choose to automatically take one of your YouTube videos and caption that. And the neat thing about this service is that when you do that for YouTube, they'll insert your caption back into the YouTube video directly. You don't even have to lift a finger. You just click this, tell them to go, and this will be a real human doing this for this particular captioning service. So that you're going to pay a lot more for. You'll be paying, let's say, a dollar a minute, or $3 a minute if you want a foreign language, or up to $5 a minute, and I think the prices are going to go up. So what this has done is it's already logged into My Keys to Music, which is my main YouTube channel, and it's identified all the videos that either have captions or don't, and I can just click on the video and add it to the cart. It'll figure out how long the video is, it'll charge me, and within 24 hours, let's say, I'll have a real human completely captioning that, listening to it, and putting all of that into text. All right, so that's one form. Let me go back here and I'll place another order. And I'm going to select automated transcription. That's the one I've been using lately. This is a fairly new service. And that's basically machines doing the translation. Not unlike what YouTube does automatically for us today. But what I like about this is it's not only extremely accurate, mind-blowing accuracy, but it's cheap. It's only 10 cents a minute as of right now, and we're February 5th, 2020. But the price is going to go up to $12.125, I think, per minute instead of the 10 cents a minute. So 12 cents a minute, 12 and a half cents a minute. So you just click upload your files or paste a URL. So if you had a YouTube video that you wanted transcribed, you can paste the URL and the machine will do that for you and give you the results, but it won't automatically insert it back into YouTube, I don't think, if you do that. But you can also upload a video from your repository and then let it chew on that. And that will be done in 5 minutes because the machine's doing it a lot faster than a human and it's doing it immediately. So most videos are 5, 6, 7 minutes max and you'll have that entire video transcribed for you. All right, so let's assume that I did that. I don't necessarily have a video I need done right now. But these are all the ones that are completely ready to go and ready for final proofing. And that's really what this video is all about. I'm showing you not only how to queue these up and get it started, but I'm showing you how to proof it and correct it. Because, of course, it's still not going to be 100% accurate at this day and age. And you'll see why here in a minute. So I'm going to go to the promo. That's over here. Let's select the promo, click on that, and it will show me the video I uploaded as a thumbnail. And it will allow me to scrub through it and get to any part of it. And as I scrub through it, you'll see that it follows along with the transcribed thing. And if you had multiple speakers, let's say you were interviewing somebody, it would actually keep track of speaker one and speaker two. It hears the different voice tones and it knows the difference between one speaker or the other. Although when it comes to Thinkific and inserting those captions, the speaker is not really important because all of that is going to be tossed away. You're going to have just a single video with the words at the bottom. All right, so I'm going to put my headphones on here in a second, and I'm going to show you what this is like. I'll just start at the beginning, and you can already see here it says, "Hi, this is Marc from My Keys to Music." Now, there's already a couple things wrong with that. It spelled my name wrong, M-A-R-C. It doesn't know that. So let's just say my name was used throughout this, and it was spelled incorrectly the whole way through. There's an option here in my editor that I can simply click Find and Replace, and I could say, find all the occurrences of Marc, and it found one of one, and replace it with Marc with a C, and then I can click Replace All, and it'll go through just like a word processor can, it does find and replace, and you can either make it case sensitive or not. So that's an interesting thing, because the machines, as good as they are, they take you very literally. They hear words, they try to construct a word in English, but they don't always get it right, because a term that I use is MIDI, M-I-D-I. That's an acronym that stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface. Well, a lot of times the machines will figure that out and say, oh, MIDI, M-I-D-D-Y, with a capital M and everything else lowercase, when it should be capital M, capital I, capital D, capital I. So that's a perfect example of where the machine is helpless to know what you really mean. Names is another example. M-A-R-C, how would it know that my name is spelled with a C? And there's really no way to tell it ahead of time that. So let's begin. I'll hit the tab key to start and tab key again to stop. We're running at 2x speed here.
Hi, this is Marc from My Keys to Music. Thanks for checking out this course.
Okay, so let's stop there. Let's fix some things. I'll just change the name Marc to the proper spelling. And I'll put the capitalization on the name of the brand here, My Keys to Music. All right, let's keep going. I'll hit the tab key. Now I can select any word and start anywhere before I hit the tab.
Checking out this course. If you are new to the world of Nord, or new to the world of the Nord Stage 3, or new...
Now here's another situation that always happens. It doesn't capitalize the word stage, and it puts the word 3 spelled out. So I'm going to go back to my find and replace over here in the top right, and then put in the word stage 3 spelled out. There's 6 of those, 1 of 6. It's finding the first 1 of 6. And I'll take this and change it to stage 3 with a capital S in a letter 3, or number 3, I should say. Stage 3, there we go. And that fixed
all
that.
Or new to synthesis, or just new to electronic keyboards in general, you might find yourself scratching your head at the amazing, robust capabilities of the Nord Stage 3. There's over 110 knobs and buttons on that control panel. And although it's one of the easier keyboards to learn because so much of it is available right there at your fingertips, there's still a lot under the hood. There's a lot for system settings, there's MIDI, there's output set.
Aha! There's our famous word MIDI here, so I'm going to fix that. Now, if I had a long document, I would also use the replace command, but I think this is the only time I say the word MIDI on this one, so I'll just fix it manually like that.
Output settings, all kinds of configurations, there's robust splits in the way that those work, there's layering, there's 3 sound engines and 2 panels.
Now, a lot of times it'll spell out things that you might find easier to put in with numbers versus words. In this case, I'll leave the word 2. And it also highlights in orange words that it's not 100% sure on.
In 2 panels.
And this is not really in 2 panels, I'm quickly saying and 2 panels.
Sound engines and 2 panels, allowing you to play up to 6 sounds.
So I'm changing the word in to and there, and that's another example of where the machines don't quite understand me 100%.
One time, it's like having 6 keyboards at your command. So there's a lot to the Nord Stage 3, and although there is a fairly well-written manual, and actually it's one of the better manuals I've read as far as keyboards go, there's still a lot that the manual doesn't really cover in terms of perspective, or why would you need this feature, or maybe just to get an expert's opinion as to whether this feature is useful or not, and that sort of thing. So if you find yourself staring down a Nord Stage 3, and you really want some video training, and just a better and more fun way to learn something as awesome as the Nord Stage 3, this might be the course for you. So if that's the case, feel free to...
Now here's an example of this might be the course for you. I actually stop the sentence there, and watch what happens when I put a period in after the O. It automatically capitals the I in if. So anytime you put a period, it capitals the next word, capitalizes the next word.
If that's the case, feel free to dive right in. Join me. This is over 9 hours of video training, over 80 different independent lessons. Each one can be taken at your own pace.
And of course, it takes your uhs, ohs, and ahs literally. But that's fine. A lot of times I just leave them in there, or you can take them out if you want it to be, you know, top notch.
You can speed me up, you can slow me down, you can pause me, you can come back and take a break. It's really amazing having this training through video. In fact, that's what inspired me to create this course in the first place. I wanted to offer...
The other thing it doesn't do is it doesn't necessarily put exclamation points. I had already edited this particular last line and put an exclamation point before I recorded this video, but it doesn't typically catch that. So we just put a period here at the end. If you want to emphasize something, just put in your own punctuation that way. So this is done. Let's go and take care of this now. Once you're happy with the edits, you can go up under here and say export. And you have several different file formats. You can actually export it to Word, a PDF, plain text. In this case, we need a special format for Thinkific. We need subrip or .srt. And notice that when I pick that particular format, all the other bells and whistles disappear. All I get to do is click export, and that's all you really need. Again, these speaker names are all going to go away, and now I've exported that. It should be in my downloads folder. Okay, I'll close this now, and I'll go back to My Keys to Music and locate that video. And at this point, I can upload that caption. So go up under captions here, click upload, click on the icon, and I'll upload the promo.srt file. All right, and I'll click upload here. Okay, now once that's uploaded, I have to select the language that represents that particular caption file. So I'll select English for this. And at this point, I just click Save. And when I do that, this icon will appear here. Okay, so notice that I had the option to auto show captions. So since I did not select that, the captions will not show automatically. The user will have to click on the CC icon here at the bottom right of the video. At this point, they can select whatever language you've pre-programmed. So you can do multiple languages. You could do French, German, Spanish, doesn't matter. And you upload those caption files for each language and have them all as a collective. And then the user will be able to select whatever language they want. So in this case, I'll select English. The moment I do that, it appears here at the bottom of the video. This feature is mind-blowing here. Search video. So at this point, that caption now has become a dynamic search mechanism. So if I put in that same word MIDI, it will show me in the text where MIDI is. It floats over my video, and then I can click on it and go to that part of the video 33 seconds in when I say the word.
There's a lot for system settings. There's MIDI. There's out
MIDI. How about that? Fantastic. The only other service I've seen do this is lynda.com. Actually has a floating transcript along with your video training. So this gives us that kind of advanced capability. It doesn't float along with the video, obviously, but it's searchable. And for those of you who are long-winded like me, sometimes there's a lot of video to scrub through to get to a particular word or a particular part of that lesson that's crucial. And having a search capability can really add a lot of value for your students. And it's just a really cool option to have. Likewise, when the closed captioning is appearing here, you'll see a little arrow, which brings you again to that same area where you can search the text, search the transcript by keywords, or just read through it and say, yeah, this is where he said it's really amazing. So let me click on that and it'll go to that part of the video. Truly fantastic. All right. So once you do that, you're essentially done. So in this video, we've learned all kinds of things. We've learned about Thinkific and its ability to create courses online. At least we talked about it. We learned how to go to rev.com, upload a video, create a new order and upload a video. That video can then be transcribed either by real humans or automatically using the robots. From there, you saw me edit the actual video transcript and I capitalized some certain things. I added punctuation. I added, made complete sentences where appropriate, changed some of the words where they were spelled out phonetically. And then after I did that, I exported it to an SRT file, imported that SRT file back into the Thinkific video, assigned English, clicked save, and that's it. I've got my video subtitles all nice and neat in my Thinkific course. Main advantages are in non-English speaking learners who need something in their native language. Obviously, translation is great. It does work well for the hearing impaired. It also works really well for those people who actually speak English who just don't want to necessarily have volume playing. Let's say you're on a train or in a quiet room with somebody and you don't want to disturb them. You don't have your headphones. You just want to watch the video and then not hear it, but just read the video. Some people love to learn that way, actually. So this gives them that option. So again, just a nice feature, nice option. I'm planning on having this on all my videos that I do with Thinkific where appropriate. I would say all of them, especially for the international speaking people. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this content, feel free to subscribe. This is not my main channel. I just do these videos simply as a courtesy, as a data dump, as far as what I've learned and what I could share to the ever-growing Thinkific community. It's exciting to be a course creator, and I just wanted to share what I learned. Perhaps a lot of you know things that I could learn too, so you can put a video out there on your own YouTube channel and let me know about it. But for now, I'm not going to be answering any comments in the Facebook group. I'm just not a Facebook kind of guy. I'm a YouTube kind of guy. If you want to ask a question, put it in the comment and I'll do my best to answer it and so forth. Thanks for watching and have a good day. Enjoy Thinkific. Enjoy being a course creator. Keep up the good work and let's train the world so we can make their lives better.